In my newsletter this week, we talk about experimentation and play and how important that is in helping you to uplevel your design skills and also to unleash your creativity, even if you think it's really well hidden. By the way, if you haven't subscribed to my newsletter, you really should. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how we can create this really cool fine art kind of graffiti portrait. And we're going to do that using only tools and assets found in Canva. So let's destroy some art. Two quick notes. The first is, apologies if I'm a little croaky, I have a bit of a cold. The second thing is that this was actually inspired by an artist called Chad Weiss, who creates these really beautiful artworks that kind of merge or blend the lines between traditional and graffiti art, and I've always loved it. So I wanted to see if, as a bit of a challenge and a bit of an experiment, I could recreate one of these artworks or something similar using just Canva. No Photoshop, no extras, just the tools and assets that I can find in Canva itself. So the first thing I wanted to do, obviously, was to create a background for this. So this is the finished work that you can see here on the screen. This was the background that I wanted to create, and all I did was I searched for the term damask, which is this kind of wallpaper pattern. I found a graphic that I could recolor, and then I just used, as you can see here, a number of them placed right next to each other to create this kind of wallpaper effect. And if I click on it and drag, you can see that's the group of four of those, and I just put it over a gray background and made this black. Now, that looks a little bit flat, so all I did next was I searched for black gradient, and I found these gradient elements, which, if I move them, you can see just goes from a very dark overlay to a lighter overlay on this side, and I put one on each side of this image over the background so that it just creates a little bit of a shade on each side and creates a little bit of depth and interest and kind of implies that there's some lighting on the center part. Now, the next thing I did was just to search for the actual picture. And the terms that I used searching for those inside Canva's library was oil painting portrait. Now, a quick note, I didn't know who this person is. I'm sure some of you will. So I just used this because it came up in the search results and it reminded me of something that I would see in one of those Chad Weiss paintings. So there's no reason for me using this particular person. I didn't even know who it was. I just thought I'd mention that because I have since found out who it is and I don't want to cause any trouble. Anyway, with this painting being here, which I really liked because the tones kind of fit with my own branding, so I liked that idea. And the next thing I wanted to do was to get a frame for it, but I wanted something that wasn't a traditional kind of gold fancy frame. So what I did was I searched for old wooden frame, and this was one of the first results that came up. And in all honesty, this is one of the key parts of this artwork, and I was really lucky to find such a great example of this kind of thing in Canva's libraries. If I just zoom in on this, you'll see that not only is it a really high quality image, but it's got these beautiful kind of realistic dents in it and little paint marks on it. And if I move it, you can see it also has a lovely drop shadow. So that immediately just makes it feel a little bit more realistic and it gives it some depth. As I've mentioned to you before, with Canva and with any kind of design, creating things that have layers and depth is a great way of making it feel more real. And so that's what I've done here with this frame. And I just put that over the image and made sure that it kind of fits and it immediately has this really nice effect. Now, the next thing I wanted to do was to kind of add the graffiti elements. And for this, all I did was search in Canva's library for a number of different search terms. I searched for graffiti, I searched for brushstroke, I searched for spray paint, and I searched for scribble. And those were the terms that I used to come up with a whole range of different results that we could have a look at. And I then just pulled in a few that I really liked and I thought could work well over this image. The crown I loved because it's kind of a reference to Basquiat, who I personally really like. The scribbles are just not anything legible, but would make a nice effect, almost as if it's been defaced on the painting. And then I liked some of the spray paint elements because they had little drips on them, so it kind of gave it that real feeling. The text itself is literally just a Canva font called Edo, and I typed in this kind of mantra that I've been using a lot lately in my work, and then if I move it, you'll see what I also did was use some of those spray paint elements, and I put that over the text in the same color to kind of make it feel like the text itself was spray painted and a little bit rough. So that creates a really lovely effect. Then little things that I wanted to do was, at the top here you'll see, if I enlarge this, I actually searched for a brass thumbtack. And I'm going to use that on the outside of the frame, along with this black line, which you can barely see there. If I zoom in, you can kind of see that black line there. Just to kind of imply that it looked like one of those staples that you find between two pieces of wood. Again, just to add that feeling of realism, but also that kind of grunge effect to the portrait. So I just recolored these with the colors of my own brand palette that's available in the brand hub that I have set up in Canva. So if I go to that, you'll see there's my primary palette, and I just used those to recolor these elements to make sure that they fit with my brand, even though we're doing something a little bit different. So before we go into how I placed these elements and bringing them all together to kind of change that picture, if you want to learn how to be more creative with Canva and also how to work more calm and confidently when you're using Canva, then I'm really pleased to announce that my Canva OS course, which is a simple system for mastering Canva, is going to be open for enrollment in a few weeks. And if you go to the link that's on the screen right now or in the description below the video, you can sign up and you will be the first to know when I open the pre-sale with an early bird discount. So do sign up for that if you're interested in elevating your Canva skills and learning some of the workflows and processes that professionals use in other design tools and how you can apply them in Canva. So back to our not so fine art. So once I had all these elements in here, all I wanted to do was then lay them over the image. The first thing I started with was just this brush stroke, which I put over the eyes, just because it's reminiscent of those Chad Weiss pictures that I showed you. And in all honesty, I really love the way that this looks. I could have just stopped here, but I wanted to push myself and experiment with a little bit more and not just stick to the kind of minimalist style that I usually have. And so I placed those other elements over this image. All I did here really was to just play around with those elements and see what they look like in different positions and how I think they could work. Now I'm just going to delete this frame for a second so that you can see these elements. And if I zoom in, you can see that here I've got two sections of that scribble which I've just turned on their side. Here I've got that scribble made larger and it overlays the spray painting of this little skull, which I thought was just kind of cute. I used the spray paint element, which I knew was going to be behind the frame, so that it just creates a little bit of depth again. And these two are also beneath the frame shadow when I replace it. Then over here, I just used these crosses and a little drip of spray paint. And I used this little love symbol just because I thought it was kind of cute. And I loved the idea of a kind of spray painted love badge on this very formal picture. So if I just put the frame back, you'll see I also added the thumbtack on the right hand side here, which most people may not notice. But for me, it's a really nice little touch. And then I added that little black metal staple that I created and I just put that at the top. So you can see those elements just placed mainly randomly, especially with the shadow of this frame, just really creates a lovely feeling of depth, and it's kind of chaotic, but over this very formal poster. So I loved that effect. Now, the next thing I really wanted to do, though, was to add something a little more interesting in terms of the lighting. Now, this can be a little tricky to do in Canva because you don't have layers that allow you to overlay or to make them transparent in different ways like you would in something like Photoshop. But it's pretty amazing what you can find if you just look. So in Canva, I just searched for light rays and overlay as my search terms, and I found this really cool image. Now, if I just reduce the size of this, I can show you what it looks like. And when I pull it up larger, you'll see it actually even has little specks of dust in the light rays. And this just worked perfectly. It's just an image in Canva that is designed to be an overlay. And when I put it over my image, it immediately creates that effect of light shining through a window. And that, combined with the shadow of this graphic, really makes it feel so real. And it just adds a lot of depth and adds a real sense of kind of movement, even though there is just these static light rays. And that's pretty much the final piece. Just elements from within Canva, images within Canva, combined to create something that is very cool and that I actually think is really fun. Now, as I've said before, experimentation and playing is really just the best way to see what's possible within Canva. Take inspiration from artwork and posters and designs that you love and try and recreate those in Canva, and it's a great way of learning what's possible. If you can spend just a little time doing that every week or every month, you'll be amazed at how quickly you up-level your skills and how much more proficient you get in terms of what is possible within Canva and what you can actually find in the Canva Elements libraries. That's it for me this week, folks. I know this was a very quick tutorial, but I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you get to play and experiment a bit more. And of course, if you're interested in learning from me how to uplevel your skills in Canva, don't forget to sign up for the waiting list for my Canva OS course, and I will announce when that's open in the next couple of weeks. Have a fabulous week.